Greetings in Jesus' name, and again, I really thank God that you're tuning in for the Rhema Word for this week, and I pray that God will bless you. There is a promise in the Word of God in Romans 8 and verse 28 of God working out everything for your good, and it says, "And we know that all things work together for good to those who love God, to those who are the called according to His purpose." Now, this is a promise that is so powerful, especially at such a time as this, when we are going through a lot of turmoil. There's the pandemic, the corona pandemic, and I believe that God has promised, and He will do it. He will make everything work together for your good. Now, there are three things that I want to mention briefly that will allow God to do everything in your life for good. Things that Paul has mentioned. Number one, it only happens to them that love God. And because you love God, because you have accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior, then believe that it's going to work for your good. You love Him. He is your Father. He cares for you. So good things will happen to you because, one, you love God. Number two, Paul says, to them who are the called according to His purpose. So the second reason why good things will work for your life, why God will turn whatever is happening in your life and turn it for your good, whether it's evil, is because you have a divine assignment. You are not just a human being living to fulfill some 80 some number of years or 90, but God saved you and He brought you into this world for a divine reason, a divine assignment. You may have a career. Your career is different from your divine assignment, because maybe you like to be a lawyer or a doctor. But your divine assignment is that thing that God has called you, ordained you to fulfill before you die. Because of that divine assignment, which is only you and you alone who can do it, then God will make sure that everything works together for your good. Number three, Paul says, and we know. So the third reason and the third way that you'll allow God to turn everything for your good, you need to have a deep knowledge, faith, that you know, that you know, that you know that God loves you, He will never forsake you, and He's working behind the scenes, doing everything to make sure that it pans out for your good. That knowledge, that knowing is called faith. So, number one, you love God. Number two, you have a divine assignment. And number three, you have faith that God is at work in your life. Let's take a brief example of this young man by the name of Joseph. Joseph went through a lot of evil in his life. He went through a pit, through Potiphar's house, prison. He was almost killed by his brothers. But in the end, everything worked out for his good. Why? Number one, he loved God. He stayed pure, even when he was tempted by Potiphar's wife. Because of his love for God, he remained holy. Number two, he was a young man on divine assignment. He may not have known it, but God knew that this is the only man that I will use to save the world from famine. Is the one that will be the prime minister in Egypt. That divine assignment kept him. God protected him because of that divine assignment, and God will protect you because of that. Number three, Joseph had faith in his God. He knew that God loves him, and he knew that God is in control. Actually, he told his brothers that you meant evil, but God meant to save a whole nation. He knew that God is at work. So this week, I pray that those 3 points will help you go through the week as you go through this season, this pandemic and hard time. Know that you love God. Know that you are in a divine assignment, and have faith that everything will work out for your good. God bless you so much for listening. I pray that this word will edify you. And as you face this week, just have faith that God is in control. See you again next week for another time of our Rhema word. Bye-bye and God bless.